What is up, guys? So today I'm coming at you with the third installment on my video series about how to get an account from level 1 to Battle Princess 3 in War Games in 1 week. So in 1 week, we're going to be at least Battle Princess 3 in War Games. If you haven't checked out the other videos in the series so far, there are two before this one. Go ahead and check those out and then catch back up to this one. And yeah, I'm just going to go ahead and get started. This is not going to be as long as the video series before this, or the videos in the series before this, because I'm not giving an objective before the next video like I have been. It's just going to be a little bit of information and not a whole lot at that. So the first thing that I want to cover is I want to go into the shop down here. I want to go to special exchange, equipment exchange, and I've already done this, but exchange for the Hestia knife. So the Hestia knife right up here at the top, you'll have an item. We've cleared the story up until 10. And we have acquired the exchange item to get the Hestia knife. First thing on the list, go ahead and grab it. And then go ahead and equip it to your bell. So I currently do not have a good bell. So you don't have to equip it to your bell if you don't want. I'm going to go into blacksmith. Go into change equipment. Bell. Equip the Hestia knife. Equip. Yep. Change the attack from 264 with the sword to 379 with the Hestia knife. And while this doesn't matter because, like right now, because this bell is not good, we're not going to be using him. When we do get a good bell in the future, which we might if we summon off of the Attack on Titan banner, the other one that we have not yet summoned off of, might get a bell out of that, and it might be good for him. So the Hestia knife is like the best weapon for bell in the game, and definitely need to pick that up. So I did want to touch on that in this video. The next thing that I wanted to talk about is War Game and Record Buster. So right now is a Record Buster season. We have a Record Buster season going on. And, you know, I just said War Game with that because if you guys are watching this at a time when we're in a War Game season, it's the same thing. The War Game season, so what I'm talking about is Record Buster. Every day there is a daily objective to get 10 Iris, just do a Record Buster mission. Play one Record Buster quest, and you'll get 10 Iris. So I'm going to go ahead and play one, actually. What I'm doing right now is I'm just turning it to difficulty 5, which there's no way us with new accounts can complete. We have just putting the bell, the bad bell in there, playing, and we get one-shotted, pretty much. We have one character going against Otaro, or whoever the Record Buster boss is at that time, but it's Otaro now, and we're just losing, like, right away. So, this doesn't take up much time, and you're going to get 10 Iris for doing it. So, it's once a day, 10 Iris, and for War Game, it is you complete 5 War Game, you use 5 War Game passes. You do War Game 5 times in one day, and you get 10 Iris. So, just go ahead and do War Games 5 times, even if your War Games team is awful, even if you don't have a Record Buster team, and then you go into time limited missions, boom, 10 Iris. All right, so, you know, in the week that we're doing this, we could potentially, there wasn't a Record Buster season started when I started this video series, but we could be getting 10 Iris a day. You know, we could be getting up to 70 Iris in that week. So that's 70 Iris that we didn't have before. So I'm going to go ahead and grab this stamina right here. But anyway, so that is the second thing I wanted to cover on. And now, along with that, don't only do what I just did. Something happened. Okay, I haven't gone in the war game, I guess. Anyway, don't only do what I just did. Put it on one and actually try one. Now, by this point in time, we have, you know, we have some characters. We have Levi. We have Eyes, we have a healer, two healers actually on my account, and then Levi, oh, Aaron, Eyes, Levi, couple healers. Like, we could survive a couple of turns in difficulty 1, so, you know, the higher that you do get in Record Buster, the more Irish you'll get at the end of the season. So, let's look at the rank rewards real quick. So, you know, if we get, let's say we're shooting for between 20,000th and 30,000th. You know, that's 200 extra Iris, and that is very achievable, probably with my team, actually. You know what? Let's go ahead and let's go ahead and try one out real quick. Let's go ahead and try one out. So I'll put Aaron in here. See, none of them have weapons equipped. None of them have armor equipped. Actually, I think Aaron might have armor equipped, but he's the only one, if he does. I'll go ahead and throw Levi in here. I'll put Fells back here. And yeah, I guess Bell. He has a weapon equipped. And then go ahead and throw the whole gang in here. All the assists that we have. So yeah, like, and this is just to show that we definitely can, probably. I'm hoping that this can get between 20 and 30,000. Turn auto off real quick, and we'll just run through this. All right, so I'm pretty sure he stuns. He stuns this season. So it's gonna be unfortunate because I do not have stun resist anything at the moment. But you know, it is what it is. Yeah, and even level one, like you saw just then, yeah, he's one-shotting. But like I said, all we need is a couple of turns, and I probably shouldn't have strength boosted on Levi, but I'm gonna go ahead and yeah, do the single target attack. I'm doing rapid slash on Bell, and up. Oh, don't kill Levi or don't kill Aaron. Oh man. All right, so that probably wasn't the best idea to do that strength boost. I didn't realize how much damage he was going to be doing. So, I guess the moral of the story is this early in your account, I guess don't boost on Record Buster. So, anyway, what was our score? What is our placing right now, actually? Ooh, I jumped up to 155th in my group, but what is my global ranking? Yeah, 14,000th. All right, 14,504. And let's go back to those rank rewards. Yeah, I'm actually in the 10,000 to 20,000s right now, which is 300 iris. So, like, I did almost no damage. Levi didn't even get to attack, and I am currently at 300 iris at the end of this week. So, that is definitely something you guys should try. And even at war game, like, if this isn't the war game season that you're getting to Battle Princess on, if this is the one prior, I know here after this Record Buster season, we're getting three war game seasons back to back to back. The one in between, the middle one, is going to be a little different, I hear, than normal war games, but still three back to back to back. So this that will be relevant, you know, at that time. So even if you're doing war game, you know, if you can grind up a few ranks, you can get another couple hundred iris that you didn't have before, and definitely should do that along with the 10 a day. So that's all I really want to say about Record Buster and war game, but you definitely should be doing that. After that, I want to talk about the Familia a little bit. So in this video, I didn't want to talk about it really in the last couple of videos very much, but I do want to talk about it. So even if you know you don't have an interest in the Familia system at all, okay? Especially right now because there's the new Familia ranking event going on, you need to join one. Even if like we're new, we have new accounts, we're really low level. Probably not going to be able to get into a decent Familia, but we can get into a Familia. Like, here's some level one Familias with three members, five. You know, here's one down here with one member. You're going to be able to get into one, and you need to because you get 50 iris for joining. And then, if you rank anywhere in the Familia ranking event, you should be able to get some rewards for ranking anywhere. And we'll go check those out in a minute. If you cannot get in the Familia to accept you though, or you just like don't like any of them, you can create your own. It does cost 100,000 Valis, but that won't hurt us too much at the moment. So if you want to do that, you can do that. But you will get that 50 Iris, and you will get some rewards. So I'm actually gonna go ahead and check out what rewards can I? Yeah, I can. Yeah, I can. So what rewards are we getting? Rewards. Personal high scores. So, I don't know what's realistic. I don't think any of this is really realistic for us right now. So we probably won't be getting any of this, to be honest with you guys. But total Familia points. You know, if you join a Familia with a few people in it, you could definitely get, you know, what is this, 10 million? Yeah, you could definitely get 10 million points between, you know, everyone in the Familia, even if we're all brand new. And that's 10 CP items, what, 100,000 Valis that we didn't have, and 20 Iris that we didn't have. And I mean, if nothing else, that's still something. That's still good. So definitely don't scoff at that. That's really good. And I believe you'll be getting that every day. Yeah, because I've been getting rewards every day. So yeah, for sure, that is awesome. And then, you know, for the familiar ranking at the end, between 10,000 and 30,000, you get some gnome tickets, you get some three-star guaranteed tickets, and you get Hero Fauna? Yeah, so, like, if nothing else, like, if your familiar is dead last, probably going to be within that 30,000 range, and you're still going to get those rewards. So, you know, it's worth it. It's definitely worth it. But anyway, I just wanted to go on that spiel about that. But yeah, I was debating earlier whether I should make a familia or not, in case you guys need to join a familia, just to get the Iris, and, you know, maybe we could get a little bit of points racked up, but I don't know. I won't for now. If you guys do want me to do that, just so we can kind of have a little familia, you know, it won't be anything. You guys will probably want to find a better familiar later, but if you need the 50 Iris now and don't want to spend any Valis doing it, you can let me know in the comments. And if you do want me to spend the Iris, I would be happy to do that for you guys, and just so you can join and get the little bit of Iris and the rewards. So anyway, I think that is really all I wanted to talk about today. I just wanted to talk about how to get that extra Iris, how to get, you know, the Hestia knife, and yeah, so tomorrow's video probably just going to be talking about some more of the event, a little bit more story, and yeah, we'll see where we go from there. But anyway, thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you learned something useful, hopefully useful. Anyway, thank you guys again. Hope you enjoyed, and have an awesome rest of your day.